No, please don't tell me that's it. Okay. Yes!
Ethan?
Yes!
Ethan!
The kid just looks scum.
I couldn't find him. Could you? He hides too well. And if he were smart, he would reveal himself.
I don't like this game anymore. Maybe something happened to him.
Ethan's fine. He's just
I win!
Forgotten this is a game.
I win.
Congratulations, your lordship.
Thanks.
Don't worry. It's just a game, Ryan.
A stupid game. I don't like it.
Why not?
I was worried you were gone.
I thought we'd never find you again.
I'm right here. And I promise, I'm not going anywhere.
I wish Mira was here. And Asha. And Roderick.
I do too. But Mira's in King's Landing and—
Can't she come home? I don't want her to die too.
Oh. Whoa.
Ryan, she's perfectly safe, I promise you.
I don't want Gerd to die either. Maester Ortengren said he got sent to the wall. I'll miss Gerd.
Garrett is smart.
He'll be fine. Garrett is smart.
No one will tell me what Garrett did, but it must have been serious. I heard Duncan and Sir Roiland talking. They said someone will come here looking for revenge.
Everyone's worried about you, but I'm not. I know you'll protect us.
Who said they're worried about me?
Well, Sir Roiland for one. He says you can't fight very well.
What?
And he calls you a milksop.
What? I'll have him punished!
Sir Roiland forgets himself.
I'll have him punished for saying that.
What does milksop mean?
I don't know. But I know it's not good.
Ethan, you should let Sir Roiland teach you how to wield a sword. Like a man. He taught Roderick and Asha, and he even showed me how to fight. Properly, I mean.
A lord should know how to fight.
Do you remember when we were younger? When we all used to play here? You, me, Roderick, Asha. We'd all be out here for hours.
Yeah. Where was I?
You weren't born yet.
Fucking idiot.
We had so much fun. But then, everything changed. Roderick became so serious, the lord in training, and he never smiled anymore. And Asha just got angry at everything. Promise me you won't be like that. Please, just be you. I like you the way you are.
I'm not gonna change.
I know a lord has many responsibilities, but you don't need to be like them.
I don't want to get angry, but I may have to. Father did sometimes.
But you're nice. Everybody says that about you.
But since you're the new lord, you can do anything you want.
I suppose.
Everyone will have to do as you say. So I could have all the sweets I want.
If only it were that simple. It would be nice if someone did what I wanted for once.
As many as you'd like, yes.
Really?
Of course. Why not?
You'll remember
Lord Ethan,
that.
You're needed in the Great Hall at once. Quickly, on your feet.
Oh boy.
What's the matter?
Lord Whitehill has arrived, unannounced, and certainly unexpected. He's come demanding justice.
What? Can't he meet with Duncan? He is the Castellan.
Stay with us. Please, Ethan.
He's demanding an audience with the Lord. We really must go.
It's your decision. You are the Lord.
If I were Lord, I would command Ethan to stay with his family. Lord Whitehill is a mean old man anyways. Someone should tell him to leave us alone.
Remind him who's Lord.
I might remind you, Sir Roiland. I'm the new Lord of House Forrester, not you.
Of course, my lord.
It's okay. You should go. It's what must be done.
Fine. Let's be done with it.
God damn it. I don't want to talk to this fuck. I'll get you all the candy, okay? Oh, boy.
They showed up unannounced. Lord Whitehill is in a lather. I assume you explained to Lord Ethan why they're here?
The business with Garrett. I told him.
Lord Whitehill knows Garrett is a squire to this house. Or was, I suppose.
Is, was. It makes no difference. The Whitehills were clearly in the wrong, so don't give him any satisfaction. Out there, you said you were the Lord. Now prove it.
I will.
Let's not do something rash. Things are bad enough as it is.
I can handle this. Lord Whitehill.
Well said, my lord.
Now is not the time to anger Lord Whitehill any more than he already is. He's got 5 times as many men, and the backing of House Bolton.
All the more reason to stand up for ourselves. Only cowards and dead men rule over.
I'm a coward. Fuck you! Who the fuck is this guy? He has stupid hair. Hi.
Lord Ethan, is it? My condolences for your father and brother. The late Lord Forrester was no friend to me or my house, but to his family it's still a loss.
Fuck your hand.
My only regret is I wasn't there to drive the dagger into his heart myself. I've been waiting for this day all my life. The Foresters finally get their due.
He died a hero.
My father died a hero, fighting for the North against traitors and oathbreakers.
Aye. And look where that got him. And no bread and salt! What kind of fucking house receives a lord with no fucking bread and salt? You bloody amateur. No courtesies. I should have expected as much. Bloody Foresters.
Apologies.
My apologies. Please forgive us.
Forgive you? Not likely. You Foresters have shit on us for generations. Well, now the Starks are no longer around to have your back, are they? We're the power in the North now.
Roose Bolton is the Warden of the North.
Aye. And we've been his bannermen for 5 fucking centuries, you cunt.
Lord Ethan. You're losing control of this.
That's enough!
That's enough, Lord Whitehill.
I'm not finished!
Too
maybe
fucking
if
bad!
Fucking greedy with the ironwood, things would have been different between us.
You squandered your share.
Our share was taken from us. We had no fucking choice but to harvest what was left.
What is it you want, Lord Whitehill?
My men were keeping the king's peace when your squire, pig farmer, started murdering people. One of mine and one of Lord Bolton's men were killed. This man, Britt, he was here. Barely escaped with his life. Tell him what that fucking pig farmer did.
Your man, the squire. We were minding our own business. Keeping the king's peace, as his lordship here said. When your man attacked us for no reason.
Hear that? Attacked for no reason.
You murdered
no
his
reason.
Family.
You murdered his family.
Then you admit it was your man who killed my men. And a pig farmer at that.
He killed 2 men right before my eyes. I saw the whole thing myself. The Bolton man. He was on his knees begging for mercy. But your squire showed none. Instead, he just ran his sword through him like he was a pig led to slaughter. I've never seen such treachery.
How do you answer for your squire, Lord Ethan?
He acted in your name, and you are the lord
did as any man
of this
would.
House.
He was defending his family as any man would, but your men murdered them all.
You lost pig farmers, not soldiers. The soldiers worth 100 of their type. Where's the fucking coward who killed my men?
I know he's here. What have you done with him?
I've handled.
Took care of it. He received his punishment, and it's done. He's gone.
What? Gone? That was my justice to deliver, boy, and you denied me of it.
I'm not leaving until I have my justice. Now bring me the coward who did it, or you'll answer to Roose Bolton.
Let me answer to him.
What fucking house is this?
A house of honorable men.
Oh,
Lady Forrester,
You bellow like a wounded boar, Lord Whitehill. Have you forgotten your manners?
I mean no disrespect to you, my lady, considering your losses and all. But this...
Fucking pussy whip!
This is not over!
It's over when my son says it is.
It's over.
This is over, Lord Whitehill.
Ethan is Lord of Ironwrath now. By rights, his word is law here. If that displeases you, then I trust you can find the door.
That lad may be lord of this house, but Lord Bolton will have the final say. I'll send him a raven letting him know a Forrester man killed one of his own. But the new Lord Forrester lied to my face and denied me my justice.
Then shit we'll in your
see
face.
Whose word is law.
You're a craven.
You're a craven, Lord Whitehill.
You're a little bitch, too, you fucking bitch! I'm gonna kill you. I think I had that.
I was wrong about your son, my lady. He stood up to him like a true lord.
You were brave, my son. But you'll need to be braver still when Ramsay Snow arrives to see you bend the knee. Prepare
bending
a raven.
No knee.
We need to send word to Mira.
Bend his fucking neck.
Once.